Do my exams next month. I'm also a gossip columnist for YV magazine.
Orla McAllister has a modelling career and has just had a baby.
I'm just going to milk my brother for everything I can. You know, I've been really fortunate to go in the house, have this massive opportunity. 2 years on, still working. I'd love to be working in 2 years' time, but even if it only lasts another 2 weeks, 2 months.
Working on my music and stuff, my album, like, I'm just trying to get that finished, basically, refined to the right level, get it mixed and mastered and get it done properly.
I'm making a living temping, which I really enjoy. Just normal work and being with people every day rather than sitting around waiting for the phone to ring. It's very disheartening.
Big Brother was about to embark on the biggest series ever.
I'm so cold!
We come one. Big Brother 7 lasted 93 days and featured a grand total of 22 housemates. With 14 entering on day one. And a further 8 over the course of the series.
Who is she? Who is she?
Love was in the air from the start, but it was Pete who became the lady's favourite.
I let you into my bed. I even let you carry on with another woman blatantly in front of me.
The thing about Pete, I think he was just funny. He was genuinely funny. He was caring, gentle type, and you could like literally feel yourself in his company.
Many strong friendships were formed. Richard and Leah, two of the oldest housemates, are still together today.
You get people said, oh, it's false friendship when you're in the house. It's like, no, it's not. It's,
you have a strong
bond. We can't get rid of each other. No. If we don't see each other every day, you can't get rid of me.
Nikki Graham was evicted on day 58.
I'm so cold!
But was put back in by the public shortly after. Best friends Spiral and Michael were kicked out the house in a double eviction.
Experience, I'd say, has opened my mind up to other people from different backgrounds and stuff like that, you know? Because a prime example, Michael, like, I don't have many gay friends, but I got evicted with Michael as my best friend and he was gay, you know? So, like, there's nothing against gays, but I mean, it just opens your mind up to it. It's just an unbelievable experience that all the time you're on the TV, you're getting to meet Davina, people are cheering you. It's like everything around you is just great. Nothing can go wrong, you know?
Come the final night, Pete proved to be the people's favourite, winning 61% of the public's vote.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Pete!
You're on top of the world.
Since leaving, the former cloakroom attendant has written an autobiography, released a single, and is to appear at the Glastonbury Festival with his band. Grace has her own newspaper column and is engaged to marry Mikey, who now works as a music producer. Nikki Graham went on to have her own TV show.
Ah, and welcome back to the Dickie and Dolly show. Dolly, how are you doing?
I'm cool, Dickie. How are you?
Good. Listen,
Leah and Richard turned their on-screen friendship into a winning formula.
We have
a radio show.
We have a radio show.
Called the Dickie and Dolly show.
On Gaydar.
On Gaydar Radio. Mm-hmm. Which is a fantastic station. If you like house music, if you just want to dance around and listen to us speak absolute gibberish, then
come
tune in.
Come listen to us.
Ashleen now presents a radio show, writes a regular magazine column, and has a successful modelling career. Glyn has put his studies on hold and recently recorded a TV documentary in Wales with Imogen, who's working as a model. Susie runs an online clothing company.
Party begins, my record spins, left turntable, bass spins.
Dublin-born DJ Spiral is now back in his hometown, fulfilling his long-time dream.
I've finished off writing my album. I had the album slightly rolled before I went in. So I finished it off, booked into the studio. I've been in the studio for a couple of months now, working on my album. And yeah, so we hope for a summer release with the album, you know, that's what we're aiming for.
Party begins, my record spins, left turntable, bass spins, right turntable, mix it in, crowd goes crazy, fit women.
When I came back to Ireland, the reception was crazy. Everyone was so supportive, you know, out in the bars, in the city centre and stuff like that, everyone coming up saying, I like the way you did this, I like the way you did that and stuff. So honestly, like, it's been, I'd say 95% for me, positive.
But not all the housemates have chosen a career in the media.
My life at the moment is in between normality, still a bit crazy and wild, but at the moment I'm going to be a plumber. I'm going to be apprentice plumbing. It's more constructive and it's more hands-on, and that's how I am. And I reckon the work atmosphere where there's loads of boys, which is a bonus, because I'm still single.
I think I'm being more realistic about the future, really, because like I say, Big Brother, I mean, like, it's a little bit of fame, it only lasts a little bit for so long, you know what I mean? So, it'd be, what I'm doing now is, like, it'd be a good career to get into, good trade, and, like, I don't know, I suppose it's better than being in the back of Heat magazine, coming out of boots or something, you know what I mean? So, yeah.
Life on Big Brother takes housemates through many different experiences, but after they leave Britain's most famous house, their lives are rarely the same again.
It was the best time of my life because it's changed my son's and my mum's life for the better now.
I would describe my time in the house as a big pile of shit. I didn't get the £100,000 and I'm bitter and I'm twisted.
You can't swim.
And Pete didn't even buy me a drink.
I'm proud to say I was one of the select few that's been there and done it.
My time in the Big Brother house is possibly one of the best things I've ever done. Not just for the time, but everything that's happened after it.
I've had a laugh, met some brilliant friends, got a car out of it. I've just loved it. It's been great.
You know, Big Brother has given me the stepping stone, which I've always kind of wanted.
The fun thing about life now is you don't get to plan it. Somebody does it for you.
Unless you have been on the telly, you don't exist.
If I could do it all again, would I? Without a doubt.
And it all starts again over on Channel 4 this Wednesday night at 9 o'clock, live.